Welcome to this video. If you use a Trace32 Trace tool to record the trace information at an off-ship trace port, Trace32 does not only allow to perform a CAD coverage analysis after the trace recording stopped, it is also capable to perform a CAD coverage analysis while recording. Trace32 uses the term real-time processing for this technique. Trace data are streamed to the host computer while recording and analyzed there immediately. This works if the data rate at the trace port does not exceed the maximum data transmission rate to the host computer. The maximum transmission rate to the host computer is currently 180 MB per second if the USB3 interface is used. This video is presented with the Trace32 version of February 2018 using Trace32 PowerView for PowerPC with the PowerDebug Pro and PowerTrace 2 connected to a Bolero 3M board with an MPC5646C processor. PowerArchitecture Nexus is used at Trace protocol here. We are loading a single core application for our demo. Please be aware that live CAD coverage is also supported for SMP systems. Live CAD coverage requires that the program code, which is needed to decode the trace, is loaded into Trace32 before starting. This speeds up the trace decoding. The option +VM advises here Trace32 to load the code to the target memory plus into the Trace32 virtual memory. I will now execute the script. First, real-time profiling needs to be configured for trace recording. By default, trace data are discarded after processing, but Trace32 offers the option to save the trace data into a streaming file. This allows the trace data to be verified one more time even after the CAD coverage measurement has been completed. If you want to do this, open the trace configuration window from the Trace32 menu Trace, Configuration, then set the trace mode to stream. Now we are done with our preparations and can enable real-time processing. Open the coverage configuration window from the Trace32 menu Cov, then Configuration, then use the RTS button to open the real-time profiling status and control window. Real-time profiling can be then enabled by selecting the RRadio button. Before we start the program execution, we have to select the metric for the live CAD coverage. I will select a source metric decision coverage. Please be aware that live CAD coverage does not support MCDC coverage, since this requires a high amount of computing. I will start then the program execution. The trace recording will immediately start. The utilization field shows the number of trace records transferred to the host. The bottom line shows the number of bytes already processed by RTS. The coverage list func window displays the coverage results at function level, and this while the program execution is running and the trace is recording. This window can be opened from the coverage configuration window or using the menu cov, then list functions. Trace32 uses the following tags for the decision coverage analysis. STMT plus DC if a function is completely covered, or incomplete if decision coverage is not achieved. Moreover, the percentage of achieved decision coverage is additionally displayed for each function. The three functions below have, for instance, a coverage of 40%. A double click on a selected item will open a source list window with more details for each source code line. The example used in this tutorial simulates a full driving test including drive and start, acceleration, and breaks. We use a dialogue programmed in practice language to simulate the different actions. By pushing the buttons of this dialogue, the values of different variables are modified on runtime. I will first start driving by pushing the start button. As you can see, the coverage for these three functions has changed from 40 to 53%. I will then push the accelerator. You can see in the VAR profile window as well as in the cockpit dialog how the speed changed over the time. The coverage of the different functions is also updated on runtime without stopping the trace. To stop the car, I will finally push the brakes. You can see how the coverage of the decrease gear function changes. Just like conventional trace 32 cut coverage measurement, the RTS mode allows comprehensive test reports to be generated. But this is covered by a separate video. Are you interested? Find more details on real-time profiling in the following Trace32 manuals. But of course, Trace32 has more to offer. Please refer to our other videos on this topic. Thanks for watching.